learn, the more suspicious it looks. And every aspect of this needs to be reinvestigated and reassessed. And as Matt says, the people who were involved need to be held accountable.
Yeah, indeed. And should we trust William Barr to be in charge of this?
I think it's difficult to do that because we've seen him protect this president over and over again. And
yeah,
we have to be concerned that if that investigation were to come close to the president or to his interests, that Barr might intervene.
Yeah, and in fact, the answer of shame doesn't help. Joyce Vance, Matt Miller, thank you guys very much. Coming up, the fear that Donald Trump's racist rhetoric intended to incite white voters could also excite militant white nationalists. That is next.
Are you afraid for her safety?
Yes, I'm afraid for her safety and the others also, but particularly her safety. And I'm sure she has some concerns and about her safety also. I hope she does, and that of her family also.
That was Illinois Democratic Congresswoman Robin Kelly talking about the fear that she has for the safety of her House colleague, Ilhan Omar, in the wake of Donald Trump's racist attack on Omar and three other freshman congresswomen over the past week.
You guys want a drink? Get a drink.
This week that her concerns are for the safety for every people around the country who look and pray like her. But Congresswoman Kelly is not alone in her concern for the safety of her colleagues. Yesterday, House Homeland Security Chair Betty Thompson sent a letter to the Sergeant at Arms calling for an emergency meeting of the U.S. Capitol Police Board to discuss potential threats to members of Congress.
How's she doing?
She's
like a ride?
Trump over his racist statements has introduced a measure to provide more security for House members.
These are dangerous times. Every member of this House needs additional security. I'm going to file a bill asking for more security for the members of this House. I want to thwart the efforts of those who might want to harm a member of this House.
So what does it mean when members of one branch of government fear for their safety and the safety of their colleagues because of the actions taken by the head of another branch of government? I'll ask security expert Jim Kavanaugh about that next.
Chloe, check in. She's right there. Just wanted to check in. I like this hike. Nice when no one's here. Oh really? Come on. There was a window. Come on, that's ridiculous. Don't you wish you had a penis?
So those threats beginning about 2 years ago, increases in white nationalist activity. Have you ever heard of these kinds of increases in hate and potential hate crimes being tied to the president of the United States?
Well, it's very, very unusual, Joy, to have that happen. You know, when you get more power, your words carry more weight. When you get into this undercurrent of the Nazis and the white nationalists and the Klansmen and this ilk, they feed off of this. They feed off of public figures on the regular media, in the government, congressmen, senators, the president, saying the things that they always say. It bolsters them. It gives them strength and power. And they're always talking. As Southern Poverty, their hate watch team just uncovered recently on the Messenger app. And they're calling.